Today we will start the new chapter, which is soil. Okay, so first we have to know that what is soil. Soil is an important natural resources. Natural resources means it is not man-made. It's a natural product or abiotic factor which is present in our environment. Plants need soil to grow. Yes, we all know that in the soil, different kinds of nutrients are present. With the help of the roots, plant absorb them. So for their proper growth and development, they need soil. Microscopic organisms such as bacteria, fungi, microscopic algae and protozoa live in the soil. Microscopic organisms means those organisms that we can't see in our open eyes. These are visible only under the microscope. Bacteria, fungi, algae, protozoa, they also live inside the soil, but we can't see them. Besides microorganisms, soil beetles, soil mites, earthworms, nematodes, millipedes, centipedes, ants and termites also live in the soil. So it means that the soil is actually the habitat of different kind of living organisms. Beside the plants, different kind of animals also, both microorganisms such as bacteria, algae, fungi and these animals such as mites, earthworms, nematodes, they also live in the soil. All these soil organisms break down the dead remains of plants, animals into simple substances, making the soil fertile. Yes, we know that in the soil, these microorganisms are present, and what the microorganisms do, they actually take food from the dead animal or plant body, and they ultimately break down their body. As a result, their complex parts are converted into simple substances, and when these simple substances are mixed with the soil becomes more fertile. So, and we depend on soil to grow crops. Crops means mainly paddy or rice, wheat, sugarcane, jute, all soil, all crop plants mainly grow on soil. So this is the soil. It's an important abiotic factor. In the soil, both animals, different kind of animals can live, and plants and crop plants also need soil to grow. Okay, and microorganisms, what they do? Microorganisms convert the dead animal and plant body into simple substances. These mixed with the soil, and the soil become fertile. So this is the basic concept about soil. Okay, now we have to know that how soil is formed, and it's an ongoing process, means it's not stopped, it is continuously happening. Now, the formation of soil, how soil is formed. See, in the beginning, the entire surface of the earth was covered with rock. Suppose this is the earth, its upper surface is covered with hard rocks. Okay? In the daytime, this is the sun. Suppose this is the sun. Due to the sun rays, the surface of the earth become warmed, and at the night it again the surface become cooled. As a result, suppose this is the earth, on the earth surface there are some cracks developed, this type of cracks due to repeated heating and repeated cooling. As at the daytime it become warmed, and at the night it cooled down. So due to this repeated process on the earth, there are some cracks formed, and by that time these cracks become widened, means increasing in length and wide. The cracks become more deeper. Okay, and what happened? In the upper surface began to break. This upper surface began to break into small pieces. Okay, in addition to this, water flow on this, wind blow also, and togetherly they contribute to form the soil. Because why? Because this water flow and the continuous blowing of wind what they do, they crushes the small pieces into fine product, ultimately which is the soil. Suppose in the cold region, mainly the in the polar region, in these cracks, the water stored, and due to the low temperature, the water is converted into ice. When it is converted into ice or snow, it also creates a pressure and also helps to form the soil. Sometimes the roots of the trees, suppose these are the roots of the trees, they enter deeply into the rocks and also make the cracks deeper. Ultimately, soil is formed. So in this way, soil is formed and it's an ongoing process. So the action of these natural factors that lead to the breaking of rocks into smaller and smaller pieces is known as weathering. So what are the natural factors? Natural factors means the sunlight, okay, sometimes rainfall, sometimes the wind, the flow of water, sunlight, wind blowing, these all are the natural factors, and these natural factors helps to form the soil. Okay, and the ultimate process is known as weathering. For million of years, weathering has converted the rocky surface of the earth into pebbles, sand, silt and clay particles. As we already know that these all the factors how convert the rocky surface of the earth into small pieces and ultimately form pebbles. Pebbles means comparatively their size is bigger. Sand means so smooth particles, silt, clay particles. These all are the elements of the soil. So how they formed? They formed due to the action of these biotic factors: sunlight, water flow, okay, wind blow, wind speed. Sometimes the roots of the plant also helps to form these soil particles. Okay. As time went by, plants grew on the land and their remains mixed with the soil and made them fertile. It means that we know that different kind of microorganisms are present in the soil. They helps to make the soil more fertile because they grow on the dead leaf. Suppose there is a tree. There is a big tree. When the leaves set from the trees, ultimately they get stored in the ground. After some times they become rotten and mixed with the soil. Ultimately the soil become more fertile. So formation of soil is an ongoing process. Means it is not stopped now. Still it is going on. The process is being formed even today. So it means that it is not stopped or a previously happened any process. No, it's an ongoing process. Means now continuously it is going on. So in this way soil is formed. What is soil made up of? Means what are the ingredients or components that are present in the soil? Mainly pebbles, sand grains, silt, clay particles and humus. So these are the main components or parts that are present in the soil. If we take some soil sample and with the magnifying glass, we can easily see the sand grains because they having a sharp edges and we can feel it. Suppose if we take a small amount of soil and with the hand if we drip it, we can easily feel the sand grains. Okay, they are transparent and of different colors, brown, light brown, yellowish, have a variation depending upon the different places. Next, clay and silt. Particles are flat with sharp edges. Means clay particles are not so sharp or not so shiny like the sand particles. They are some little bit, there is a difference, and also not transparent and appear dark, means dark brown in color or blackish in color. Whereas the humus appears dark but don't have any sharp edges. Humus means the smooth part of the soil, very smooth fine powder like part, and they don't have any sharp edges and not flat like the clay particles. This is the three parts, main parts that are present in the soil, and they have a different features. Soil also contains air. Yes, within the soil oxygen is also dissolved from the root, absorb it. It is present in the space between the soil particles. Suppose this is the soil particles. There are some space in between them which is filled with the air. This space are filled with the air. Okay. Soil also contain minerals and some amount of water. Yes, we know that when rain, after raining, the rainwater is collected by the soil. So soil also contains water. Plants absorb this water through their root. Not only water, different kind of important minerals are present, which is highly required for the plants during their photosynthesis processes. These minerals are soluble in water, means they are easily mixed in the water. Plants absorb some of this mineral along with water through their roots, that I have said already. So this is the ultimate today's class. So first is the basic concept about soil. Next, how soil is formed. Soil is formed due to the action of some biotic factors, sunlight, raining, wind speed, water flow. Okay, sometimes the roots of the trees also. And the process is called weathering. Weathering process means the process by which the upper rock surface of the earth is converted into soil. Okay, this process is called weathering. Next, the components of soil. Means what are the in the soil, mainly grains, clay particles, humus that are present, and they have some different features also. And within the soil, air is present, water is present, and some minerals are also dissolved in the water. So this is about the today's class. So students, first go through the three pages up to here. Okay. And I have given some short questions also, multiple choice questions. Write it in the copy. Okay. Thank you.